Hello everyone, I am back. Summer is over and I, as promised, made again to you my new video, and as promised I started showing you every my project what I will make on summer. So first of all, I must say thank you so much to René, because I received the summer package from René, and I asked René send me some American ephemera. So René sent me this, and I must tell that I will need more American ephemera. And to whom possible, please send me more American ephemera, and because I wanted made special American journal. So this ephemera I will need to that journal what I planned made. And on this summer I will try made some experiments with colored paper and some fabric. Why colored? Because I decided to use don't paint. I decided to use something else what gave color to paper and to fabric. And this process I will start it on summer, but I don't finish it because I will think what use else to color it paper and fabric. So I will start it, show it you from paper, and after I will show it you fabric. So just because on summer, as you will know, I will go and grab some blueberries, I decided try to colored paper from blueberries juice. So this is this paper. I hope you will so great. This side and this side. And this is ordinary paper from some big notepad. It look like light violet, and it is. Maybe I will show you on this way that you will so better some elements. I will like how it turned out because I will not boil it, just put on juice with little bit water, so it have this effect. Maybe on camera you will see don't great, but it looks really great. Have these dots, blueberry dots. and don't have any smells. And you will see here, this is white part of this paper, this is colored part. So it's to me great. This paper was from some school maps. School maps. I decided to use this part to make some maybe tag, maybe something else. I don't know. I'm going to show it this. And it's great. Blueberry juice gave, as you will saw, some darkness and light tones to paper. So this is copyright paper. This. So I will use the, from notepad paper, from some geographic maps and copyright paper. And why I will make this paper, because I will plan it, make some journal and use all of this colored paper. And also, I will use on this journal and my colored fabric. So this is last piece of this paper. And also I will try colored some book page, but it's not. Maybe you will gave some color, but not exactly much, because it was last of this mix, juice and water. So this is this. Also, I will try, I will saw some time ago some technique with watercolor, so I will try make some paper. Technique is, I will put this paper here, so technique is, as you remember, put use some color and fold paper and print that part on this part. So I will make this one. And I will make this one. So this three. And I will like this technique. So if I will have possible to I will make another more actually paper, and this base I will found this printing picture, so I will use it on my paint paper. Also I will try to use some lace like a stencil. I saw that many people used it and I decided this summer also used lace as a stencil, so I will color it some book page. So this is, I will use handmade alcohol ink, what I will made some time ago, it's long time, I will have it. So this is that. This is this paper. And I will think when I will color it this paper on some store, I will saw dry drink in powder. So I will think if it possible to color it paper and fabric on this way. Sorry. And I buy two on one color package. This and this. So if be honestly on paper this don't work. But on fabric, what I will show you later, it works every very great. So when my paper don't dry, I will use orange alcohol ink and just drop on this paper with water. So this is the result. This paper is, as you will saw, not it's a parchment, but from some cookie. I will dry. So, and after, when I will dropping this alcohol ink, I will also drop in some coffee. So it's looks like so. Maybe here you will see better. So this is this is my paper from colored from this dry drink in powder, and actually I will tell on this paper this is not work. This work on with fabric. So if you try to color, use this powder drink, color it only fabric. And also on this summer I will rusting some paper, some fabric. And about this fabric I will make separate video, because I will rust lot fabric. And when I will when it's was ready on the end process, as you know, used water with salt. So this water was like rustic water. So I will try color it another paper, but maybe I will make something not exactly, because my paper not rust, have only some little bit some marks, but not rust as I want. So this is this. Maybe I will close my, and you will see better, or maybe not better, I don't know. Have some marks, but not exactly. So this is another. This is the last. So this is paper what I will color it on this summer. Now I will show you fabric what I will color it. So the first fabric with blueberry juice. It's big piece, and I will try used only fabric what I will found. What I will found, and this is that fabric. It's light, have light color. Have light color, but is looks great, really great. I will like it. So this is first. Another piece. And I will try colored some jeans. But here, little bit have color of blueberry juice. Here don't. And on the edge, it's you will saw little bit of the color, but camera don't show it you this color, but believe me, it's with jeans blueberry color don't work. So this is this. Also I will try used I will try color it some fabric with coffee, because actually I don't made I color it only paper, but fabric don't color it. So this is the first piece, and you will see here little bit darkness, little bit lightness, lace. Here don't, on this side don't, but on this side you will see a little bit darkness, little bit. So it looks like a grunge. This is the first. Another lace. Maybe I will put here paper. Not, you will don't see on this paper. Then maybe my jeans. It's big piece with lace. And it's actually about lace, I don't remember, found this or send me someone, but I try to make. this lace. You will sew this lace like white, but it have some coffee dyeing marks. So this is this. Maybe here you will sew better this marks. Here, this. Yeah. So this is the first lace. This lace you will see maybe, but I hope you will see grungy edges. Here also grungy edges. So it's also big piece, and this piece I will found actually somewhere, I don't remember where. Coffee dyeing marks. So it's big here also. It's big. So this is my next lace and my fabric. And my fabric. I hope on fabric you will see better. So, okay. This is one side. This is one side. This is another side, and on another side it's better, so you will see much more. Grungy coffee dyeing fabric, colored fabric. So this is my result of the of my experiments. Ah, not all. And I will try to make some mixed media. Actually, not exactly mixed media, but also I will use that lace, what I will color it. Paper or to color it fabric, and it not will great to with work with spray, but maybe with paint it works better, but on this time I don't have any paint, so I will use my handmade spray. And this is this fabric, not made many, only one. Here you will see that lace marks. So this is that, this is that. So this is all actually. All painting fabric and paper and not all, sorry. Painting with dry drinking powder. It's have lightly orange, but you will maybe don't, you will see white, but it have lightly orange. This one. This is more intensive orange. And this is more intensive orange, but I tell lightly, very lightly. So maybe I will use this dry powder drink not exactly right, but this is result, and actually I will like this result. So on this time is all of my fabric. Really old, all. And this is actually part one of this part one about my fabric and paper, because I will try rusting another fabric. So on part two I will show you my rusting fabric. So if you interested in this, go to the next video and watch and write what you think about this my fabric. To the next video.